buckling up just before we embark on an inspiring journey with Teddy Nalubwa, a woman defying the odds in Uganda's male-dominated trucking sector. This 35-year-old mother of three from Kayunga District is on a simple mission, transporting trailers from the depot to Bugolobi, a Kampala suburb. As she confidently maneuvers the roads, it's clear that gender doesn't matter behind the wheel.
Overspeeding leading to road accidents is one that claims many lives today. This is due to the reckless driving of many truck drivers. Today I met Teddy Nalubwa, a 35-year-old lady, a mother and a truck driver. In 22, Nalubwa joined truck driving training in Kasese. Today she's among the best truck drivers from Safeway, Uganda.
However, Nalubwa copes with stress in her own unique way, and she faces hurdles, especially when her family needs her.
For my family, for my children, and being a single mom, really, I leave them in Kampala, I go to Kasese, I work. But just that the good connection I have with my bosses, when I tell them my baby is sick, they let me go. When I tell them I have to go for visitation, they let me go. When you request their, you know, I think they understand us as mothers. It affects in some way that you don't have that enough time for your family, for your kids. They need you, but you're not around them, you're far from them, because we really travel, we really move a lot. Even if I try to, because there's a time I took my kids to Kasese for like a month, but still I would not be around. You leave them in the house, you travel, 2 days you're not home. Or you come back and tomorrow early morning you're off. You come back at night when the baby is sleeping, you leave him sleeping, you know. But at the end of that day, you're looking for their future.
Before diving into the trucking world, Nalubwa worked as a professional counselor. She earned a bachelor's degree in counseling and guidance from Chambogo University in 2014. But when the COVID-19 pandemic hit, she lost her job. Determined to make ends meet, she ventured into farming, which didn't bring in enough money. Frustrated, Nalubwa decided to learn how to drive manual cars.
Driving. So, when I was starting to learn how to drive, I said I will not learn from these small cars. I learned from a double cabin of a friend. He taught me just on the road. I didn't go to a driving school. Taught me just on the road, but I picked within a few days.
Nalubwa started her driving journey with a manual car, driving her father whenever he needed to go somewhere. A stroke of luck came when the owner of G&K Chizito informed her of a truck driving opportunity at Safeway. She is among the 10 Ugandan women who recently qualified as professional truckers from the institute. Nalubwa had never driven a truck before and had never seen a Ugandan woman doing so.
I dream driving a truck. I really love it. I'm proud of it. I can't say enough about how I feel. There's a friend.
Her dreams stretch far beyond East Africa. She envisions herself crossing borders, delivering cargo across the vast continent of Africa. Her trainer, Derek Fetter, can't help but sing Nalubwa's praises.
Nalubwa has been a determined woman, very cooperative during the whole training, willing to learn and always following instructions while on her training. We are not surprised that she came out as one of the best candidates from this training.
And when it comes to trust, Dickson Mwesigwa, the sales and marketing officer at Victoria Motors, puts his faith in female truck drivers. He confidently asserts that once women acquire the necessary skills, they become incredibly careful behind the wheel.
I would encourage women to also look into the truck driving field. We need many, many drivers to join the field. A lot of the drivers we have been driving for more than 30 years, and it's been difficult for us to retrain them into what is now required in the market. But what we are seeing with women is that most of them are coming into the field fresh, and it's easy to adapt them to what is required in the market.
When the government introduced the National Equal Opportunities Policy in 2006, it put emphasis on the empowerment of women.
Equal payment for equal work are important for us. Issues of preventing gender-based violence, because quite often women are subjected to a lot of economic exploitation. They are also subjected to sexual violence. I will really appeal to Victoria Motors to look into some of those issues and support the women to deliver their work.
As for Teddy Nalugwa, her journey is far from over. While she hasn't yet ventured beyond Uganda's borders, she has already conquered hundreds of kilometers on her remarkable path. Sharon Navasidie, on the Mobile Storyline in Kampala.